Welcome to Learning with Dr. Shivangi. Today's topic is Concept of Human Resource. As we started the play series for the Human Resource Management and already discussed about the Personnel Management, and its elements also. So in today's video, we'll discuss about the concept of human resource. What is meaning of human resource? What is concept of human resource? We'll discuss in this video. Before starting the video, I want to say you that if you like my video, please like and share this video, and don't forget to subscribe my channel, which is Learning with Dr. Shivangi. Now coming to the main topic, which is concept of human resource. Human resource is the most important part, most important element of any organization. A human resource can be referred as the essence, as the gist of an organization. The six major resources of a business organization are man, money, materials, machine, method, and management. They are known as six M's in the world of business. Except man, all the five others are useless resources without man. Because for the functioning of all these five M's, which are money, materials, machine, method, and management, can't work without man element of the organization. They are conducted according to willpower of man or human resources. So all five M required the man for the working of functioning of these five M's of the business. In the words of Elton Mayo, who rightly remarked that man is a resource since man acquires enthusiasm in work through fulfillment of social demands and feels satisfied through self-expression, through maintenance of individuality among his own community. Man's willpower, efficiency, innovative attitude, conscience, mental power, etc. have made man the best among all the resources. Because man has the curiosity, willpower, enthusiasm, self-motivation, and building or managing the whole of the elements of the organization. So it is the most important resource of the human resource, most important part of the organization. Till some time back, if a business was asked as to what was his most valuable asset, he would have pointed towards his land and building or plant or machinery, maybe goodwill or brand image or some other materials thing. But the times have changed now, and the importance of human resources is being realized in every organization. Because human can change the scenario, can change the condition of any organization with the help of other five M's in the organization. Although the field of personal management have been with us for nearly 70 years, only recently there has been some major redirection concerning its importance. For many years, personal management was viewed as a maintenance function for the organization, a repository of records and information, but not as a function that had any noticeable impact on the productivity and profitability of the organization as a whole. In the starting period of development of human resource management in the organization, personal management known as the maintenance function of the organization, and after that, after few time, it is noticeable that it is important impact on the productivity and profitability of the organization as well. Increasing complexity and size of most organizations has resulted in multiple layers of bureaucracy. All organizations and establishments have realized the increasing cost of manpower. Over-bureaucratization have been operating to isolate employees from both the organization and the competitive advantage in which most organizations must operate. So operation of human resources is also very important for the organization. But the time taken, the cost of manpower is also increased time by time in the organization, which includes different types of costs, for example, recruitment cost, salary cost, training and development cost also. Greater government involvement in human resource practices are causing all organizations to re-examine their policies and practices. The legality of costly wage settlements or court awards and the increase in collective trade union disputes in most organizations all over the world have increased the growing importance of personal policies. Because there are so many disputes occur in the union of the organizations, so by these disputes, by the legalities, by the involvement of government, policies are making an improved for the human resources day by day in the organization. Increased educated elements in the workforce are causing all organizations to re-examine their assumptions about their employees' capacity to contribute, as also to impose limitations on the productivity or profitability of the organization. And the changing values of the workforce, particularly relating to authority, are causing all establishments to re-examine how much involvement and influence employees can have in organizations and the mechanism to recognize their voices of protest. So re-examination of assumptions or policies which are related to employees, which are related to human resource management, have some limitations also on the productivity, on the profitability of the organizations. These policies may be related to salary, wages, rights of human resources in an organizations also, which gives also authority to the human resource who are working in the organizations. More concerned with careers, the life satisfaction are also causing organizations to re-examine traditional assumptions about career planning, to provide more alternative career opportunities, as also to take into account employees' lifestyle needs when transferring them. So these career planning and life satisfaction also remembrize the members of the organization to change in the manpower planning policies, to employees' policies, to change them, to transfer them according to the benefit of the organization, according for the benefit of the employees also. Changes in workforce demography, particularly the infusion of women, minorities, and handicapped persons into organizations, are making them re-examine their policies, practices, managerial values that affect the responsibilities, treatment, and advancement of these employees. Recent researchers have developed a perspective of strategic human resource management. So these type of human resources, which are women workers, minority workers, handicapped persons, are motivate organization to re-examine their policies towards human resources and change their managerial values to impact on the responsibilities, treatment, and advancement of these employees. So this is related to strategic human resource management. This perspective essentially takes a broader, more integrated view of the personal function. It seeks to link the personal function to the long-term strategies of an organization and ask how it can facilitate the accomplishment of those strategies and goals. In this environment, the importance and status of personal management will continue to increase as a field which proactively and creatively responds to changing requirements and expectations of human side of any enterprise. So by the changing time, human resource importance is increasing day by day in the organization, which also move to change the policies related to human resource. So this is all about the concept of human resource. I again summarize all the points so that you can easily understand about the topic. What is concept of human resource? What is meaning of human resource? It is the most important element among 6M, which are money, machine, material, method and management, and men. It is very resourceful, very important element, because without men, all other 5M in the organization can't work without men. This men parties also include different types of costs related to human resource, which are maintenance costs, salary costs, equipment costs, training and development costs also. But it is a very important part, very important element for the development of organization. By the changing time, it is also useful for the organization to change their policy related to human resource management, related to personal management. By the changing time, the workers, which may be women workers, which may be handicapped workers, which may be minority workers, motivate organization to change their policies, to change their programs related to human resources in their organization, because human resource is the most important element, most important part of the organization. So this is all about the concept of human resource. If you have any query about this topic, or if you want to know about any other topic related to human resource management, business management or research methodology, you can ask me through comment box. If you like my video, please like and share this video, and don't forget to subscribe my channel, which is Learning with Dr. Shivangi. We'll meet in the next video with new topic. Thank you everyone.